Namaste.
Namaskaram. As part of Muthuswami Dikshitar's celebrations, or celebrating Muthuswami Dikshitar's Leg Den series, part 2, we are with Muthuswami Dikshitar and Thiruvidai Marudoor. How Muthuswami Dikshitar has viewed Thiruvidai Marudoor, the Kshetras in and around Thiruvidai Marudoor, and more details about that will be discussed in this lecture demonstration.
ஐந்து கரத்தனை ஆனை முகத்தனை ஐந்து கரத்தனை ஆனை முகத்தனை ஐந்து கரத்தனை ஆனை முகத்தனை இளம்பிரை போலும் ஏற்றனை நாதி மகாதனை ஞான கொழுதினை உந்தியில் வைத்து அடி போற்றுகின்றேனே நமச்சிவாய வாழ்க நமச்சிவாய வாழ்க நாதாய் வாழ்க இமை பொழுதும் என் நெஞ்சில் நீங்காதான் தாய் வாழ்கழியாண்ட குருமணி தாழ் வாழ இறைவனடி வாழ்க
நாதஜோதி ஸ்ரீ முத்துஸ்வாமி தீட்சிதர், as we all know, is a bit traveler. He has traveled to numerous kshetrams, both in all the four directions of the country, predominantly in the south. The topic of the lecture demonstration is Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim, which might seem a bit out of place for some, because that is the name of one particular kriti that we have taken. People might wonder, how can we talk about one kriti for, say, a whole lecture demonstration? That is what this humble attempt is going to be. Chintaye Mahalinga Murti. Mahalinga Murti, or Kailayanatha, as he is fondly called, is Shiva enshrined in Thiruvidai Marudoor, or Madhyarjuna Kshetra, in the beautiful Solya Desa. this is a very ancient, a very powerful and a very predominant temple in the Sola Desa, which calls for lots of concentration, tapas, and lots of meditation that needs to be put, that each they should have put, just to compose that one small song. Seeing the Kshetra Purana, the Sthala Purana, we come to know so many things which Dikshita has very intelligently and effortlessly blended into the lyrics and the music of the compositions. We will start off with the Sthala Purana. Before we start off with the Sthala Purana, all of us are very well aware about the Jyotirlingams in our country. As many of us know, there are 12 Jyotirlingams. I will be reciting a prayer called the Jyotirlinga Stotram, Dvadasa Jyotirlinga Stotram. So here, the house it goes.
Saurashtve Somanathamscha Shri Saive Mallikarjunam Ujjainya Mahakalam Omkaramalleshwaram Pralayam Vaidyanathamscha Dakinyam Bhimashankaram Setu Bandetu Ramesham Nagesham Darukavane Varanasyam Tu Vishvesham Triyambakam Gautami Tate Himalaye Tu Kedaram Girisham Stashivalaye.
These are the names of the 12 Jyotirlingams. If we recite or just think about these 12 Jyotirlingams, what we get?
Ye Vedanis Etanis Jyotirlingani Sayam Pratha Patenarah Sapta Janma Kritam Papam Smaranena Vinayashyati.
Just by thinking of the names of the 12 Jyotirlingas, the sins that we have accumulated for the past 7 births get vanquished in a second. We are very well aware about the 12 Jyotirlingas, and we very frequently go on yatra to these Jyotirlingams and have darshan of Swami, you know, these Jyotirlinga Kshetras. As I already listed out the names, Lord Shiva or Parameshwara is enshrined in each of these temples with particular names. He is called Somanatheshwara in Saurashtra. He is called Mallikarjuna Swami in Sri Sailam, Ramanatha Swami in Rameshwaram, and so on the list. But in no temple he is there as Lingam himself. This is the only Kshetram where Swami is nameless, because he is in the form of the Purna Parat Brahma Swarupam. We go to any Shiva's temple, we can ask the priest, what is Swami called here? He will tell the name as Vaidyanatha, or Halasyanata, Hatakeshwara, Achaleshwara. But there will not be a name called Mahalingam. That's a very weird name, and a name that makes us think, why such a name? Why Mahalingam? Lingam is the form in which we see Lord Shiva. That cannot be the name itself. A form cannot be a name. But that is how it is there in this temple, and the reason we will see in a few minutes. Why I told about the 12 Jyotirlingams is, the power of this Kshetram, Tiruvedi Magadur, is so much that even if you don't visit all these 12 Jyotirlingams and you visit Tiruvedi Magadur once, you get the power or the benefit of visiting all the 12 Jyotirlingams and more than that. The Linga Purana and Skanda Purana give names of 12 other Shiva Kshetrams where Kailasa itself is there on the earth. It tells you need not go finding for Kailasham anywhere. like Kailasham is there on earth, where Swami along with his consort Devi is there in their complete conscious form just to bless us devotees. The first is Kashi, then we have Srikalahasti, then we have Arunachalam, Tiruvarur, Tiruvannamalai, Tiruverkam, Chidambaram, Tiruvangadu, Mayuram, Kumbakonam. These are the 11 kshetras. The Linga Puranam adds the 12th name of Tiruvidai Maradur and completes the list. Why the Linga Puranam has added the 12th name of Tiruvidai Maradur is the Linga Purana talks about the importance of seeing Shiva in a Linga Swarupa. And here in Tiruvidai Maradur is Mahalinga Swami. The greatness of Mahalinga Swami cannot be topped completely even by the thousand-headed snake Adisesha. Even he becomes tired telling about his prabhava, telling about his powers. We will try our level best to tell about him. The temple itself is, as usual, this, as any other Surya architecture, it's a very beautiful temple, but weird in few forms. Usually, Surya temples are filled with sub shrines. Other than the main deity, you have small shrines, many small shrines inside the temple. In the prakarams or temple corridors, you will find numerous Shivalingams, you will find numerous Ganapatis, you will find numerous Devis, but this is not so in the case of Tiruvidai Maradur. It is all empty, it is all neat. It is not neat exactly, it is empty. The prakarams are empty. You find there is in such a big temple, there is only one Ganapati shrine, there is only one Subramanya Swami shrine, there is only one Devi shrine, there is only one Durga shrine, only one Chandikeshwara and one huge Nandi. This makes us wonder, why is it so? There is so much space which is left out empty. Why couldn't the things that could have easily constructed shrines? Why didn't they construct? That hints, that question finds its answer in Dikshita's compositions. I am reserving the Dikshita's composition for a little while later so that I can finish my talk. Tiruvidai Maradur. This is how it should be said. Tiruvidai Maradur. The kshetram that has Maruda Maram as its thala vriksham, or Arjuna vriksham as its thala vriksham, is called an Arjuna kshetram. This is called Madhyarjuna kshetram. Why is it Madhyarjuna? Because there are three temples having Arjuna vriksham as its thala vriksham. One is Srisailam, the second is Tiruvidai Maradur, the third is Udarjuna. You can see Arjunam being incorporated so beautifully here. In Srisailam, Swami is Mallikarjuna. In Tiruvidai Maradur, he is Mahalingamurti or Madhyarjuneshwara. And Udarjunam, the name itself has the name Arjunam. So out of these three places, Srisailam is in the Andhra region, which becomes the north. Tirunelveli, Udarjunam is in the south, and Sola Desam is in the beginning. As this Arjuna Pradesham, as Tiruvidai Maradur is in the between, it is called Madhyarjunam. The one Arjunam that is in between. Now I would like to elaborate a little about his physical form. You would have already seen a little of him in the poster that we sent out. But that no way does justice to what we physically go and see happen in the temple. His form is enormous. The priests have tried hugging him, and each time they hug him, he grows bigger. Mahalingam. The temple is constructed in such a way whichever place you stand, you will be able to see Swami, Swami will be able to see. There are many such beautiful aspects of the temple. So now I think it's the time we listen to the first composition of Mr. Swami Dikshitar. First composition as in for this lecture, Chintake Mahalinga Murti in Raga Varaju Tala Adi.
Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim, Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim, Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim, Chidrupa Spurtim Sukirtim, Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim, Chidrupa Spurtim Sukitim Chintaye. Santatam Madhyarjuna Puravasam, Santatam Madhyarjuna Puravasam, Santatam Madhyarjuna Puravasam, Brihat Kuchamba Sagavasam, Santatam Madhyarjuna Puravasam Brihat Kuchamba Sarvasam Antaranga Bhakta Jananam Antaranga Bhakta Jananam Ati Samipa Rujumargadarshitam Antaranga Bhakta Jananam Ati samipa rjumargadarshitam Antakantakam adhidharakam Hatyadipaparam puraram chintaye Antakantakam adhidharakam Hatyadipaparam puraram chintaye Mahalinga Odim chidrupa spurtim Sukitim Chintaye. Pakashasanadi Deva Brindam, Pakashasanadi Deva Brindam, Palita Dasa Janadi Mukundam. Pakashasanadi Deva Brindam Palita Dasa Janadi Mukundam Shokadi Harana Padaravindam Shokadi Harana Padaravindam Shubhakaram Karunarasakandam Shokadi Harana Padaravindam Shubhakaram Karunarasakandam Shri Kamalapura Somaskandam Chinambareshwara Nadanahanandam Shri Kamalapura Somaskandam Chinambareshwara Nadanahanandam Shri Kalisha Bhairavaskandam Shiva Swami Shaira Guru Bhaskandam Shri Kamalapura Somaskandam Chidambareshwara Nadanahanandam Shri Kalisha Bhairavaspandam Shiva Swami Shaira Guru Bhaskandam Chintaye Mahalinga Odim Chidrupa Spurtim Sukirtim Chintaye Mahalinga Murtim
That was the Paraju of Muthuswami Dikshitar, Chintake Mahalinga Murtim. I am awestruck and I do not know where to start talking given this kriti. Is it the lyrical beauty should I talk about, or the musical setting that he has used, or the grammatical word beauty that he has played with, the Dikshitar's forte is prasam. It is called Dityakshara prasam, Antakshara prasam, many kinds of prasams. Should I elaborate on that? I do not know what I should talk and what I should do. Let us first skip to the Sthala Puranam and then move into the aesthetics. The Anupallavi first line tells Santatam Madhyarjuna Sthalavasam or Madhyarjuna Puravasam. Exactly the name of the Kshetram Dikshitar has given us, telling us the address of Mahalinga Swami. Want to see Mahalinga Swami? Go to Madhyarjuna. Santatam Madhyarjuna Puravasam. He is not moving away anywhere from Madhyarjuna. He is going to be only in Madhyarjuna. Madhyarjuna has many other names according to Puranas, but Dikshitar has used only Madhyarjuna. There is a beautiful story behind it. Swami and Ambal, or Shiva and Parvati, were once meditating in Kailasha. According to Shaiva texts, Shiva was explaining his wife, Shakti, the Shiva Rahasyas. And Devi, as an obedient student, was making notes of it. She is an amazing student. She was listening to it. But the Guru, Swami Dev, adorns the role of a Guru. His mind immediately changed and he went into the state of Samadhi. And she is scared, even though she is his wife. She is scared even to go and touch him. So she is in a shock and he goes to Samadhi for some time and then opens his eyes. He makes it on his lap and both of them on a golden palanquin evacuate. They shift from Kailasham and Swami can take you to a place where you understand Shivatat was better. He chooses Madhyarjuna and Swami and Ambal come to Madhyarjuna. Kailasham, if you imagine Kailasham to be a person, Kailasham is always in bliss having Swami and Ambal on his head. Kailasham immediately feels very light, wondering where is Swami and Ambal has been to find Swami. He takes the form of a human being and comes to Bhuloka and starts searching. Then he finds Swami and Ambal in the form of Guru Shishya, or simultaneously in the form of a husband and wife. There is both Shringaram and Guru Shishya Bhavam between them. Swami is the Guru, Dakshinamurti, and Devi as an obedient student and an obedient wife listens to what he has to tell, and they are in a beautiful state in this Madhyarjuna Kshetra. So Kailasham comes and runs and surrenders at the feet of Swami. What mistake did I do? You left me and came here. And Swami looks around him and tells, there are all Arjuna trees around me. I will do one thing, I will take a huge balance. I will place you at one end. I will place Madhyarjuna at another end. Whichever place is more heavy, I will go there. Swami tells that. Madhyarjuna becomes 10,000 times heavier than Kailasham and it falls down. Kailasham trembles in fear. Kailasham himself trembles in fear. That should be the better way of telling. And he surrenders at the feet of Madhyarjuna and he requests Madhyarjuna, let me be one of your Arjuna trees here, serving Swami. And he becomes the Arjuna Vriksham, which is the Sthala Vriksham till now that we see in the temple. And this is the only temple where special pujas and pradakshanam is done to the Sthala Vriksham. Even when we go to the temple, we can also go around the Sthala Vriksham and do special prayers. It is equivalent of going around Kailasham itself. So Dikshitar very aptly uses the word Madhyarjuna. There are many other names for Madhyarjuna Trivada Madhu such as Sarvatirthapuram, Jyotipuram, Shaktipuram, Dharmavrutipuram. Dikshitar would have known more names than this. Trivada Madhu, he could have interpreted in any other way, and Gandhi could have put, but he has put only Madhya Arjuna Puravasa. And aptly the next time, Bhrithak Puchamba Sahavasa. Devi is beautifully called Bhrithak Puchamba. The reason I will explain when we sing that Kriti. He tells, Hatyadi Papaharam. What a Sahitya knowledge. We can, you know, we can't even think of creating such sahityas that can match those kind of things. Once a king, Varaguna Pandian, was infected or had Brahmaharti Dosham. So what is Brahmaharti Dosham? Brahmaharti Dosham is the dosham or sin one gets when one has killed a Brahmin. Brahmin in the sense of person who has who performs lots of good deeds, praying for the welfare of the others. One who kills a person who prays for the well-being of others gets the sin of Brahmaharti. So this king gets the Brahmaharti dosha. So he comes to Tiruvadi Maradur, and the moment he enters the temple, the Brahmaharti moves away from him and sits in the eastern Gopuram. And then he goes into the temple, he performs all pujas, he worships the Lord. And the Lord advises him not to go through the same Gopuram, the same entrance. So the Brahmaharti might catch him again. So he goes through another entrance when he is exiting from the temple. Even today, when we go into the temple through the eastern entrance, we find a small shrine for Brahmaharti. It is very auspicious to go and have a darshan there. Brahmaharti, even though it's a sin or an infection, it is depicted as a very beautiful, funny-looking child with a big head, small body, big moustache and all. It's very aesthetically pleasing one. Also, it is a very powerful one in terms of removing, helping us getting rid of all the things that we might have accumulated in our previous lives. So the sin of killing someone is called hati. Hati papam is the papam that we get by killing someone. So hatyadi papaharam, the one who is an expert in getting us relieved of all the sins that we get by killing someone. Dikshita refers to the story of this Varaguna Pandya, you know, how he got rid of the Brahmaharti dosha. This is a very, very subtle phrase that Dikshita has incorporated in this. Dikshita incorporates the same phrase in another Kriti. Ramanatham Bhajeham Ramachandra Pujitam. Rameshwaram. There also a person is getting Brahmaharti Dosham. Sakshashi Ramachandra Swami is getting Brahmaharti Dosham because he is killing Ravana. Ravana was a Brahmin. Even though he was a Brahmin by birth, he had evil thoughts. So Ramachandra Murthy adhered to the dharma of killing him as a Kshatriya, true Kshatriya, and to get rid of the sin, he does Shiva Puja. There Rama does Shiva Puja, there Varaguna Pandya does Shiva Puja. By doing Shiva Puja, one is relieved of the papam of Hatyadi Papaharam. Doesn't mean you have to kill someone to do Shiva Puja. This is one of the 1,000 benefits or 1 lakh benefits of doing the Shiva Puja. That is a very beautiful detailing and Dikshita gives even in Ramanatham. A very nice Kashi Rama. Next is the most beautiful phrase of the Raga Mudra. Listen.
Ati Samipa Rjumargadashitam Antaram भक्त जनाना अति समीप रुजुमार्गदर्शितम्
अति समीप रुजुमार्गदर्शितम् This is how the song goes, the lyrical content goes. But when combined, it becomes Atisami Parajumarga Darshitam. Paraju, I don't know whether it is a Sanskrit word also. Like how we sang Navaroz the last time. Navaroz, Paras or Paraju. Like how? We can't even imagine of creating Sahitya now with the Ragabhudras of Paras or Navaroz.
In fact, there would be other composers who would be taking Paraju Raga Vinute, Paraj Raga Vinute.
Yeah, maybe they can tell Paraju Raga Vinute, Navaroz Raga Vinute. But nobody can do such geeky stuff. Next is my personal favorite, the Madhyama Kala of this composition, the Charanam Madhyama Kalam, which we take as the fulcrum to expand the whole lecture demonstration.
Shri Kamala Pura Soma Skandam Chidambareshwara Nadanadanandam Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam Shiva Swami Saida Guru Guha Skandam Chindayen Shri Kamala Pura Soma Skandam Chidambareshwara Nadanadanandam Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam Shiva Swami Saida Guru Guha Skandam Chindayen Mahalim.
Before we move on to that, can you sing the first line of the Charanam?
Pakashasanadi Deva Brindam Palita Dasa Janadi Mukundam.
Yes. Another reference to Sthala Puranam, we get in this, the first line of the Charanam. Pakashasanadi Deva Brindam. There are three levels, Akasha, Bhumi and Patala. If all the devas or the demigods had to come to the earth to do some puja, they will go to only to Trivadamurugan. That is why
Palita Dasa Janadi Mukundam.
Trivadamurugan has another name, Dakshina Kailayam or Dakshina Kailasham. Trivadamurugan is considered as a Shiva Kshetra. The whole Solamandalam becomes a Shiva temple. That is what Deepshira tells in the Madhyama Kalam of the Charanam. Shri Kamalapura Somaskandam Chidambareshwara Natanandam Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam Shiva Swami Shaila Guruguha Spandam Guruguha Skandam. So let us go further and explore what is there. So I was listening to this composition by a famous musician, and these lines somehow didn't seem very appropriate. I thought Deepshira was just revising through all what all compositions he has sung. That didn't seem appropriate later then. So then when I did some more reading, or
let's put in the recent terms, research.
Research, yeah. That's how people like it to be called. I found a very beautiful, interesting thing. The Garbhagriham of Trivadamurugan Mahalinga Swami is there. It's a very, I'm not sure whether the lingam, the bimba of the temple, the lingam that we see, is sculpted or not. I'm not sure about that. But if we see him, it looks as if Swami has eyes and he's seeing us. From the, if you take, imagine eyes over the Shivalinga and you draw a straight line opposite, you land up at a place called Tiruvadurai. Just opposite Swami, land up at a place called Tiruvadurai, which is a Nandi Kshetra. Usually in a Shiva temple, just opposite to Swami, we have Nandi. Just opposite to this Madhyarjuna Kshetra, we have Tiruvadurai, which is, people go there to worship only Nandi there. And it is also said that Shiva himself, Swami himself has conducted the marriage of the Nandi there. There is some history associated with it. And if we come as a pradakshanam around Tiruvadaimadur, we first landed at Alangudi, which is a shrine for Dakshinamurti. Then we land up at Tiruvagur, our ever favorite Tyagesha, who is in the form of Maharaja, the Bhoga Murti of Swami. Shiva in any temple has five murtis. Linga Murti, which we see in the Shivalinga form. Bhoga Murti is the Soma Skanda. Then is the Nartana Murti of Nataraja. Veera Murti of Veerabhadra. Ugra Murti called Bhairava. Five murtis in any Shiva temple. Sometimes the instead of Veerabhadra, you might have some other form. It depends on the temple. Instead of Veerabhadra, it is a Shanta Murti called Dakshinamurti. Mm-hmm. According to the structure, according to the rituals followed in the temple, this order varies. Here we have a Shanta Murti, Adanguri Dakshinamurti, Bhoga Murti, Tiruvarur, Tyagesha as Somaskanda. Then if you go further on, we land up at Tiruvaranjudi Shweta Ganapati, which is exactly in the place where Ganapati shrine should be. Then further on, we land up at Swami Malai, place where Murugan or Subramanya Swami Sannidhi should be. Then a further more prakshanam, we land up at Tiruvai Padi. To the exact left of Swami comes Tiruvai Padi. To the exact left of Swami, in any Shiva temple, we find Chandikeshwara. And Tiruvai Padi has a huge Chandikeshwara shrine. And then further down, we land up in Sirgadi. Sirgadi famous for the Ugra Murti Bhairava. And a little away, if we come to Suryanath Kovil, which is where Surya along with the Navagraha Mandalam are present. So the whole of Suryadesam becomes a Shiva temple and Madhyarjunam becomes a Shiva shrine. So we are going to see how Dikshitar has composed most of these kshetrams, if not all. Before going to see other kshetrams, we will do a little more on Tiruvadaimadur and the heroine of this temple, Bharat Pichamba. Two eyes are not enough to fall in love with her beauty. Her sannadhi itself is a very unique sannadhi, not how a usual Devi sannadhi in a temple will be. As far as I remember, we climbed up a few steps to go to her shrine, called as a Mada Sannadhi as we usually tell. It is done so that elephants won't come into the shrine.
Okay.
Elephants can't climb narrow stairs.
Okay.
So, before we talk about her, this kshetram is very famous for its Tirtham. In any kshetram, any temple, there are three important things. Sthalam, Murti, Tirtham. Sthalam is the name of the place. Murti is the name of the god or goddess residing there. Tirtham is the temple tank.
So, kshetram, Murtam, Tirtham.
Yes. There are 36 Tirthams in this temple, out of which the most famous one is the Karunyamrita Tirtha. Dikshitar, as we already know, doesn't give out even a single detail. But Dikshitar doesn't talk about the Karunyamrita Tirtha in the Paraj Raga Kriti that we stand now. But he talks about it when he describes the goddess. Let us see how. Before that, let us listen to the very poignant, very beautiful Dhanyashi Paradevata Bharat Kuchamba Dhanyashi Raga Kadikani.
Tadarinanna परदेवता बृहत् पूजाम्बा परदेवता बृहत् पूजाम्बा संरक्षतु मा श्री जगदम्बा परदेवता बृहत् कुचाम्बा संरक्षतु मा श्री जगदम्बा देवता शारदा सल्लूत सकल शरण चापेय पुष्प पद युगल शरण चापेय पुष्प पद युगल वर गुरु गुह जननी चिन्मालिनी स्थिरतर संपद प्रदान धनिनी वर गुरु गुह जननी चिन्मालिनी स्थिरतर संपद प्रदान धनिनी पर देवता चराचरात्मक प्रपंच जननी चारु चंद्रहासिनी सुवासिनी चराचरात्मक प्रपंच जननी चारु चंद्रहासिनी सुवासिनी चिदानंद महालिंग मोहिनी चिद्रूपिणी भक्त विश्वासिनी करुणारस प्रवाहिनी कौलिनी कलिकल्मष नाशिनी हंसिनी करुणारस प्रवाहिनी कौलिनी कलि कल्मषनाशिनी हंसिनी कलामादिनी कात्यायनी कलामादिनी कात्यायनी कञ्जलोचनी भवपाशमोचनी कलामालिनी कात्यायनी कञ्जलोचनी भवपाशमोचनी परदेवता जग अम्बर देवता बृहद
I think I got the place where the Deertham is mentioned. Karuna Rasa Pravahini.
Exactly. There are a few more points also. As we all know, Dikshadat has some special love towards goddess, be it a Mahalakshmi Kriti or a Saraswati Kriti or a gentle goddess Kriti itself. There is a special power Dikshadat gets while composing them. It's not Dikshadat's effort that he puts, but goddess puts efforts to take out words from him. She's like, please, I want more from you. This is a very powerful Kriti that, you know, that makes one want more, listen more and more again and again. And once you, and the raga itself, Dhanyashi, so meditative, it's so, it has such prayogas that makes one fall in love with the raga. Teach it as Mayuranatham or this Paradevata or
Mangaladeva
or Ranganathaya Namaste.
Too many.
You cannot, words are not enough. And the meditative mood that this song takes us to is incomparable. Prathama Vibhakti, first Vibhakti, such alliterations that Dikshadat uses, he makes us one again and again. We get this sense of such a awestruck. We get awestruck and they're astonished by choice of words exactly, or how words fall in tune with the raga. If you want to just chant words, then you have to automatically with it. The raga cannot be separated from the words. So when we come back to this Thala Purana, there is a story that tells many rishis or Siddharthas did tapas in the kshetra and they took the form of champaka trees. Champaka, the flower is called champaka in Sanskrit, shenbakam in Tamil. The champaka aranyam Dikshadat tells in Saveri, Shri Raja Gopal also. So the rishis take the form of champaka trees and they do tapas to attain the goddess's feet. And but this kept one side. Lalita Sahasranam describes goddess while comparing champakam to her nose. It is Navachampaka Pushpava Nasa Danda Virajita. Or Champeya Pusnapriya. Generally it tells goddess likes champaka. But this nasal compare that it tells Navachampaka Pushpava Nasa Danda Virajita, the nose bone of the goddess, how a newly bloomed flower would look like. But this nowhere goes there. In the composition, there are many places, Sharada Rama Sandha Sakala, where it is Ramara Rama Vani Sabhidakshana Sevita. This is Dikshadat's standard favorite Kamali from Nirta Sastam, Kamalambam Bajare, Shri Rama Saraswati Sevitam. There are many places where Dikshadat loves using this phrase again and again. But he tells Sharat Champe Pada Nirvada. Because the rishis are doing tapas not to attain nose, but to attain her feet. Sharat Champeya Pushpa Pada Yugada. Many rishis believe that we wishes to Tiruvada Maradu now also they're thronging to be born as a champakam, as a vriksham of a champaka tree in Tiruvada Maradu. And they whenever Ashvacharya, they crave that, won't I be plucked to be offered at her feet? This refers to that tapa of attaining moksha through that, through this phrase. Can you see that phrase?
Shara champeya pushpa padayugala.
Padayugala. It is not a single feet. Pair of feet.
Oh.
The rishis are thronging. That's why that goes to the upper thigh. The tapa is so much in the rishis' minds, the rishis' hearts, that they want them immediately. They want moksham, but they won't grant them moksham so easily. She puts us a lot through a lot of struggle and all. That is another story. But that tapa is reflected through a beautiful upper sthayi prayoga, the meal sthayi prayoga, typical Dhanyashi prayoga. So now let us travel. All, yes, physically we are not able to travel because of the virus issue that's going on, but through music nobody can stop us traveling. Before we travel, let us first travel to the place called Tiru Aadadure, the place of Nandi. Okay, there is a beautiful Tamil play of words that comes in the play of Tiruvaadudurai and Tiru Idai Marudu. One meaning of Tiru Idai Marudu is the Marudu Maram. I already told Arjuna Vriksham is in the middle of the other two Arjuna Vrikshams. Madhya Arjuna Kshetram, that is one. Idai in Tamil, in another meaning, refers to Vrishabham or the Nandi. Tiru Idai Marudu. So Swami and Ambad, I told, came from Kailasham to this place, Tiruvidai Marudur. They came on a Nandi, it seems. Not a normal Nandi, Tiruvidai Marudur, a special Nandi. Nandi himself is very special. We have so much of Tada systems, 108 Talams, 35 Talams, Shudaris of the Talams. The one who has mastered all the Talams is Nandi. The one who plays the Mridangam and while Shiva dances is Nandi. So we can have a smarana of him just by the name of Tiru Idai Marudur. It is not just Tiru Idai Marudur. One is Tiru Idai Marudur by telling it is in the middle. Another is Tiru Idai Marudur. How? We should tell.
Uttunga Kamaniya Vrishaturangam. Uttunga Kamaniya Vrishaturangam. Bhairavi prasangam guru guha tarangam prithivi lingam chintaya mahakandam mulakandam uttunga kamaniya vrishaturangam bhairavi prasangam guru guha tarangam prithivi lingam chintaya mahakandam mulakandam.
Thank you. Yashidhar enjoys, he is in a state of excitement whenever he sees Swami on a Rishabham or a Nandi Vahan. Be it Distintaya Makanda Mulakantam or Tyagaraja Padayashramam or Mayuranatham where he is Nandi Kesham or Hatakeshwara, if I am not wrong.
Nandi, but then that comes as part of the
other people who worship Swami.
Swami,
yeah. Yes. So Dheerishitir is in a state of bliss. He is excited to see Swami who is riding, who is on Nandi. So Nandi is a very important thing. That thing we have covered, Nandi. Now let us move to Tiruvalanjuli. Tiruvalanjuli, the last lecture demo itself, we have done a little bit of Tiruvalanjuli because it is Ganapati Murthis. Each place has its own beauty. It is Tiruvarur Theralagu. திருவலன் ஜொடி பல்ஹணை அழகு. பல்ஹணை இஸ் தி கேனல் கார்வின் செராய் ஜனவரி. இட் இஸ் தி பியூட்டி ஆஃப் தி டெம்பிள். தோஸ் ஹூ ஹவ் கான் ஹூ ஹவ் நோட்டிஸ்ட் இட் இஸ் டன் லைக் இன் அ பேனல் அண்ட் பேனல் அண்ட் பேனல் அண்ட் தென் இட் இஸ் ஜாயின்ட் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் அக்செப்டட். தேர் இஸ் தி பியூட்டி ஆஃப் திருவலன் ஜொடி. Even though it's a Shiva temple, the temple gets its power from the Ganapati who is situated in a remote corner. He is just in a remote corner, but
he is commanding.
He is commanding. Like, he is the source of power for the temple, storehouse of power. The temple is also called Vellai Pillaiyar Kovil. As you know, Geechil has exactly called Shweta Ganapati in the composition. Once what had happened, Indra along with other demigods, the Devas, was fighting a battle in the Kshiravdi or in the ocean of milk. And every astra, every weapon that he was putting on the asuras went in vain. Nothing was working out. And then he prayed to Lord Shiva and he prayed to Lord Shiva. And then he realized that he had not worshipped Ganapati before going on a venture. So then he tells, you worship Ganapati now. But around him everything was water. He couldn't worship. So what he did, what the best that he could do is, he collected all the froth that was there from the water. It's called
the milk
or the liquid around him. We do not know whether it exactly is milk
or water. Or milk plus water.
All the froth he collected and he made a swarupa. He invoked Ganapati in it and he worshipped him. After worshipping, he left him in a remote corner. Telling that he will take him to Devaloka after he finishes the battle. He came back, but the Ganapati was not willing to come back from there. So he left him there as it is. And now we see him in Thiruvaran Juri, which is near Swaminarayan. I am tempted to go back a little bit to the Ganapati Kruti's lecture demo. This tells Thiruvan Rudi. Rudi in Tamil means a little, circle
world,
or whirl. Whirl is usually found in a liquid. Like. And it also refers to the Kundalini. I'm tempted. I don't want to go so much into it.
We have
so much else to talk. So before, I just want to hint that it talks about the Kundalini. And as you already told, there are 2.5 circles that Kundalini takes and resides in our human body before it activates, before it untwirls itself. The first composition is okay. The third composition for today will be Shweta Ganapati. In Radha Chudamani. Dikshita very beautifully hints at the shloka that we usually tell. Gajananam Bhuta Ganati Sevitam Kapitta Jambu Phalasara Bhakshitam Umasutam Shoka Vinashakaranam Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam. This is a shloka Ganapati prayer we have been telling since we were kids. We just keep telling as a part of our daily prayers. Dikshita remembers to incorporate it in his composition and it appears as the first line of the Shamashti Charma.
Shweta Ganapatim Vamadeva Pratipadyamanadyam Shweta Ganapatim Vamadeva Pratipadyamanadyam Shweta Ganapatim Bhuta Ganadi Samsevitam Buddha Guru Bhuta మాతంగముఖం వల్లభాసమేతం విరాగ చూడమణి శ్వేత గణపతి మాతంగముఖం వల్లభాసమేతం విరాగ చూడమణి శ్వేత గణపతి వామదేవ ప్రతిపాద్య మనాద్యం శ్వేత గణపతి వందే
That's where the Viraga Chudamani.
This is the Raga, Raga Chudamani. And the Raga Mudra appears as Viraga Chudamani. A well-wisher of ours, after listening to the previous lecture demonstration, beautifully added to this composition. The Sampradaya Pradashini tells Mundi Shweta Ganapatim Vamadeva Pratipadhyamanadhyam. It doesn't give Vande. There is no verb in this composition. She very beautifully told that actually. A dear friend of mine from Delhi, Srimati Shubha Prada, she told, Viraga Chudamani appears. That is why there is no verb. Because Ganapati here is in a state of Viraga. There is no action. He is in actionless form. He is in the highest state of Parabrahma Swarupa. Again, I am tempted to quote Adi Shankaracharya. Here, his Shanmatha principles, Ganapati is reflected here. We have, again, we are going to talk about Adi Shankaracharya in the coming compositions. So, because he is in the state of Viraga, the highest Parabrahma Swarupa, in spite of having his wife Vallabha right on his lap, he is unaffected. He remains unaffected. So that is why there is no verb. Ganapati is not also not doing any verb. We are also not doing any verb. We are just being a spectator in front of Ganapati, just receiving his blessings. That being said, we will move on to the next place. The only possible hill that one can see in this world is Malai, Swami Malai. This is not a natural hill, but some texts tell that it's a Kattu Malai, or it has been built to look like a hill. And wherever there is a hill, there will be Subramanya. Mm. Dikshitar, and whenever I tell Swami Malai, it is very a reminder of the Natri composition, Swami Natha Paripali Ashram. But today, I'm not going to do that composition. We will hint at that composition, obviously. Before doing that composition, we are going to have a very beautiful Vilahari today. Dikshita here, again, this is also a Prathama Vibhakti. It's not so Prathama Vibhakti today. We have some
other
Vibhaktis. We have some variety. So happens like that. Dikshita, he tells Swaminatha Paripalayashumam in that Kriti. He tells here, he invites Subramanya to sit beside him as though both are friends. Opposite, that's what.
Okay, fine. Okay. Sorry, my bad.
Swaminatha Paripalayashumam, that is where the contrast comes.
Okay.
Dikshita doesn't quote his guru's name unnecessarily. In his first composition, Srinathadi Guruho Jaiti Jaiti, he tells Sri Chidananda Nathoham iti Sankatam Hridayam Bhaja. Then there is a mention of his guru's name, Uchishta Ganapato. Only when there is absolute necessity and when he feels this composition requires his guru's name, he quotes. Chidananda Natha is Muthuswami Dikshita's guru's Dikshanam. Who tell that it is Dikshita's Dikshanam itself. But whatever it is a spiritually a Guru Sthana position given to someone. It could be to Swami Dikshita or his Guru Chidambaranatha Yogi. if you consider that it is the, it is Bhutu Swami Dikshita's Diksha Nama, the Diksha Nama is given to a person by his guru. Even then it is Guru's Prasadam. So he doesn't quote it unnecessarily in all the Kirtis. Even in the Kamalamba Navavarnams, he doesn't use it.
I think he uses it in that Arabic.
He uses it in the Akhilandesh.
Like Namaste. Chidananda Nath Guru
Bhupa. Yes. He uses it in this Kirti. Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha. Agacha Agraganya. Shri Chidananda Nath Varenya. So why Dikshita uses his guru's name is because the Swaminatha Swami is in the form of a guru. The concept of guru, nobody else but Dikshita can explain it to us. The very concept of guru is explained to one in the form of Dakshinamurti. There is a very beautiful statement that forms an exclamation. The guru is young and the Shishyas are old. Dakshinamurti is very young, Swami is very young, very youthful. And all the Shishyas, the Sanakadi, say, Rishis around him, are all 90 plus year old, all white hair, unkempt hair. Yes, Dakshinamurti is very well combed, shiny hair. His tiger skin is neatly folded and maintained. Very well groomed he is, both physically and spiritually. So the concept of age doesn't come, physical age doesn't come into play in between the guru and shishya. The same concept of Dakshinamurti is what Shiva Swami shows in the play of Muruga and King, explaining the concept of Pranabhava. So before we go more into the details of this composition, let us listen to this beautiful Kahari, Shri Bharamani and Agacha.
Shri Pala Subramanya Agacha Gaganya Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha Gaganya Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha Gaganya Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha Gaganya Shri Chidananda Nath Varenya Shri Chidananda Nath Varenya Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha Gaganya Shri Chidananda Nath Varenya Shri Bala Subramanya Agacha Abala Gopavidita Dina Sharanya Abala Vidina Dina Sharanya Abala Gopa Vidina Dina Sharanya Atma Prakash लावण्य कारुण्य आत्मा प्रकाश लावण्य कारुण्य आत्मा प्रकाश लावण्य कारुण्य बाल सुब्रह्मण्य आगचक्र गण्य बाल सुब्रह्मण्य आगच्छ सनकादि सन्नूत स्वामी नाथ सनकादि सन्नूत स्वामी नाथ सनकादि सन्नूत स्वामी स्वामी शैलस्थित सोम तात स्वामी शैलस्थित सोम तात नक बल्ली देव सेनो वेद कनक बल्ली देव सेनो वेद कैवल्य दात सकृ विभात कैवल्य दात सकृ विभात वनज वदन पद पंके रुह वनज वदन पद पंके रुह वरदाश्रित कल्प महीरु वनज वदन पद पंके रुह वरदाश्रित कल्प महीरुह मनसि ज जनकादि सेवित कुमार दीनतरहर गुरुह श्री बाल सुब्रह्मण्य वनज वदन पद पंके रुह वरदाश्रित कल्प महि रुह मनसि ज जनकादि सेवित कुमार दीनतरहर गुरुह श्री बाल सुब्रह्मण्य गच्छग्रगण्य चिदानन्दनाथ वरदेण्य श्री बाल सुब्रह्मण्य आगच्छ आगच्छ
Balasubramanya, a young boy, as Dikshitar sees him, Bilahari a very suitable raga for him.
For the playful, for the joyful Bala,
would go very well. Very exciting, gives very lots of happiness. It's not a damn happy that he didn't use any Nigali or any.
In fact, he didn't use the. So there is this Hatakeshwara composition in Bilahari. That treatment of Bilahari is very, like extremely slow different. And very down.
Yes.
This is like very vibrant.
The Kamakshi Bilahari is totally different.
Madhurapuri Bilahari.
Madhurapuri Bilahari is yet another composition. So, Dikshitar uses the same raga according to the deity, according to the geography of the place. So, can you sing the Atma Prakash?
Atma Prakash.
Atma Prakasha Lavanya Karunya. Swaminatha Swami's beauty is not just his physical form. His beauty is the Atma Prakasha, the light that gives us moksha. Again, he tells Kaivalya Data. It is not just the beautiful hand holding the veil or the hand holding the. Yes, he's very attractive looking.
His hands are cool.
Yeah, obviously he's dancing. But it is not just that. Diksha very beautiful hints. That is the reason I felt we should do this composition game for this link them. As I already told, Sanaka the Rishi is worshipped.
Madhyarthi Rakshita.
No, Sanaka the Rishi is worshipped. Are being advised by Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti himself is being advised by Swaminatha. That is why we have Sanakadi Sanyuta Swaminatha.
Parama Guru of Sanakadi.
Again, Dikshita shows us the importance of the Guru Parampara. That's why the Pallavi itself he told Chidanandanatha Varenya. Dikshita is very strictly, he very strictly adheres to his Guru Parampara, be it his spiritual gurus or his musical lineage, the Venkatamakhi Parampara. He doesn't go even a bit away from his musical parampara. He doesn't compromise on that. Unlike
other
contemporary composers or people of this era who are willing to change guru settings.
Let's talk about this.
Yeah,
that will become controversy. Let's not do that.
Then we have Sanakadi Sanyuta Swaminatha. Swami Shaila Sthita. The name of the hill itself is Swami Malai. Swami, the word Swami refers only to Murugan, only to Subramanian. So it is Swami Shaila Sthita Soma Tata. The one who is having Shiva as his father is Soma Tata. Kanaka Valli Deva Semopadeta, those are self-explanatory. Kaivalya Data Sakriti Pada. Can you see that?
Kaivalya Data Sakriti Pada. Kaivalya Data Sakriti Pada.
This line, when we keep revisiting this line or keep mulling over these lines, it feels that this line is the soul of this composition. It is not. Rajesh invites Subramanya not just for his handsome looks or for the place that he is staying, but for the Kaivalya Data. Dikshita talks about all the iconographic details. He tells Kanaka Valli Deva Semopadeta, all other iconographic details. Although he gives that, his main aim is Kaivalyam. Be it any deity he addresses his compositions to, his focus is never changed. We have found that in all compositions, even in forthcoming compositions. That being said, enough being said of Swami Malai, I will just finish up with another detail. Swami Malai has small shrines of Shiva and Parvati, and Dikshitar quotes that slightly he said that in the Natai composition. Swami Natha Paribhari
Vamadeva Parvati. Vamadeva Parvati Sukumara. Vamadeva Parvati Sukumara Varijastra Sambodhitakara. Vamadeva Parvati सुकुमार वारिजस्त संबोधितकार.
This is not just details about who Murugan's parents are, or just reference to, yes, this is a huge guideline to tell that there are small shrines of Swami and Amba in the temple. This also is a huge life lesson for us, that wherever we go, whoever we are, even if we are the guru of, even if we have become great gurus, we are not supposed to forget our parents. He is Swaminatha. But still, Vamadeva Parvati Sukumara. Well, being said, we'll go to the next shrine. Our personal favorite, Shripuram, Chamatkarapuram, Kamalalayam, Kamalanagaram, and the names end this. We are now going to Tiruvarur. Tiruvarur forms the Bhogamurti or Somaskandamurti when we see from Tiruvadaiyur. Earlier, Swami Malai and Tiruvananjuri were the Ganapati and Subramanya's shrines respectively. Now for this Kshetram, he will be rendering Tyagaraje Krityad Pratyam in Saranga Ragam Jhampadari.
Tadara Tyagaraje Kritya Krityam Arpayami Videha Kaivalyam Yami Tyagaraje Kritya Krityam Arpayami Videha Kaivalyam Yami Shri Tyagaraje Bhoga Yoga Marge Bhukti Mukyat Marge Bhoga Yoga Marge Bhukti Mukyat Marge Tyaga Ragatmake Tatvam Paratmake Tyaga Ragatmake Tatvam Paratmake Shri Tyaga Rajin Prakriti Purushatmake Pancha Bhutatmake Prakriti Purushatmake Pancha Bhutatmake Prakriti Vikrita Atmake Panchi Krita Atmake Prakriti Vikrita Atmake Panchi Krita Atmake Sukriti Hridayatmake Surya Chandratmake सुकृति हृदयात्मके सूर्य चंद्रात्मके विकृति भेदात्मके विश्वेश्वरात्मके विकृति भेदात्मके विश्वेश्वरात्मके सुकृति पूर्णात्मके सुरगुरु गुहात्मके सुकृति पूर्णात्मके सुरगुरु गुहात्मके सकृद सकृदात्मके सचित सुखात्मके सुकृति पूर्णात्मके सुरगुरु गुहात्मके सकृत असकृदात्मके सचित सुखात्मके श्रीयागर्वजे कृत्याकृत्यम् अर्पयामि विदेह कैवल्यम् यामि श्रीत्यागर्वजे कृत्याकृत्यम् अर्पयामि
I think, just to add to this, the prasam of the Pallavi, the Vithi and the Prathama Akshara, both the prasams are like Tyaga Raja, Kritya Krityam. So Tyaga is also there, Kritya Krit is that Ka Akshara. Kaga is also going there. What a genius. Whatever, yeah.
The Anupallavi starts with Bhoga Yogatmake. Bhoga is the worldly enjoyment, worldly pleasures that you get. So I don't think any other murti enjoys Bhoga as much as Tyageshwar does.
In fact, Bhoga and Yoga.
Bhoga and Yoga. First, let us talk about Bhoga.
Fine, okay.
The level of music, level of dance, the level of flowers, amount of ornaments he wears, jewelry ornaments, accessories, silks he wears. No other Shiva temple has so much of importance given to alankaram and outer appearance given. Yoga, yes, there are many Shiva temples that focus only on yoga. Then homas, tapas, yagams, japams and all go on all Shiva temples. Either only that is there, or only this is there. But a combination of bhoga and yoga is found only in Trivaru.
And the funny part is, he's Tyagaraja. And he is with bhoga.
That is the
irony
there. He is called Tyagesha. I don't know what he sacrificed. Maybe that is for you to tell us. I don't want to expand more on this Kriti owing to the destruction of time.
And again, this can become another
lecture. So, little bit of surprise there. We come back to Tiruvadai Mallur. As I already told, every town in Tamil Nadu boasts of its own beauty. Tiruvarur er alagu, Tiruvananjuli palkanai alagu. ஆவுடையார் கோவில் கொடுங்கை அழகு, திருவிடை மருதூர் தீதி அழகு. To translate in English, the beauty of திருவாரூர் is in its chariot. The huge, humongous, magnanimous, giant chariot festival that takes place. The annual chariot utsavam that takes place, the rathotsavam that takes place, is the beauty of திருவாரூர். திருவஞ்சுழி, as I already explained, is using the panel carvings. Tiruvadai Marudur's beauty lies in its streets. the well-planned architectured streets is the hallmark of Trivadimudu. When I talk about these streets, I can't skip the point about the Mahadanam Theru. Mahadanam Theru or Mahadanam Street is a very important street in Trivadimudu. It was given as Danam or as gift to Appaya Dikshitar. The whole Agraharam, the whole colony was given as gift to Appaya Dikshitar by the kings. So when we talk about Appaya Dikshitar, we will use Appaya Dikshitar as a fulcrum again to connect Trivadimudu with another kshetra. Then I was thinking whether this can be done. A man whom I love, I admire, I respect, and I surrender myself came to my head. No other than Sri 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 Chandrasekhar Saraswati Mahaswamihal, Mahatelugu as you fondly call him, came to my help at the right time. A very beautiful vrittam that has been immortalized by Chennamuri Srinivasa here. Before he sang, it was Mahatelugu who brought it to the spotlight. A very beautiful shloka written by Appaya Dikshitar in Sanskrit. I will tell the shloka and I will give the literal meaning of the shloka. With that shloka as the fulcrum, we will move on to the next piece. Maulau Ganga Shashankau Karacharana Tade Sheetalanga Bhujangaha Vame Bhage Dayadra Himagiri Durita Chandanam Sarvagatre Itam Sheetam Prabhutam Tava Kanaka Sabhanatam Sotum Kvashakti Chitte Nirveda Tate Yati Bhavati Nate Nityavaso Madhiye. This is a very beautiful shloka written by Appaya Dikshitar on Nataraja Swami. Appaya Dikshitar, as many of us know, was a huge devotee of Lord Shiva. He has written this shloka addressing Lord Chidambaresha or Lord Nataraja at Chidambaram. He tells, Maulau Ganga Shashankau. You have three things on your head. One is, you have two things on your head. Maula, Maulu, Maulau or Mauli means top of the head is called Mauli. Especially for a deity like Shiva who loves doing hair styling. The top of the head is called Maula. Mauli, Chandra Mauli. Incidentally, the Swami worshipped by Mahabiriva and in Sri Matams for Chandra Maulishwara. So Maulau Ganga Shashankau. He has Ganga and Shashankau. Ganga, as we already know, is the river that is on Shiva's head. Shashankam. Shashankam refers to Chandra. The name Shashankam is because when you see a full moon, it looks like as if a rabbit is sitting. Shashank means a rabbit. Ankam means a form. Rabbit-like, translated in Sanskrit, becomes Shashankam. So, Maulau Ganga Shashankau Karacharana Tale Sheetalanga Bhujangaha. He is wearing ornaments. What ornaments he is wearing? Sheetalanga. He is wearing something called Sheetalanga. Snakes are always cold in nature. Their skin feels always cold. Appaya Dikshitar tells us this. He is wearing them as ornaments. Then he is telling, to your left side, there is a lady. Vamhe bhage dayadra. She's wet. Ardra, she's wet. But what is she wet? She's wet with compassion. Dayadra. Himagiri dakuta. Himagiri suta or himagiri duhita. Chandanam sarvagatre. I smear you completely with chandanam, or you are smeared completely with chandanam. This can be viewed from another angle. This is the literal meaning I am giving. Shiva is always cold. There is Ganga on his head. There is moon on his head. Lady sitting beside him is also cold. She is also wet with compassion.
Again, she is also cold because
she is the daughter of the snow-capped mountain. They are sitting in a cold place, which is Himalayas. Appaya Dikshita screams. He tells, "Oh Chidambaresha, if you want warmth, if you ever want to feel warm, just come into my Hridaya for a second. Because my Hridaya is boiling. It is boiling with tapa. Because when someone is having the feeling of tapa, I might be using the word tapa again and again, but tapa might refer to yearning. Tapa again is of three types. Dikshita again says tapa traya ritene. Lalita sahasranam. This again very well stems with Lalita sahasranam. Tapa trayagni santapta samahladana chandrika. Tapa trayagni. All three tapas becomes like agni inside a person. So he tells, "Oh Ishwara, if you ever want to feel warm, or if you are warm, it means that you are inside my heart." So the same thing, if Bhakta is feeling hot because of the agni of tapa or agni or yearning, goddess becomes the chandra, the full moon. Tapa trayarni santapta samahladana chandrika. Chandrika because of the feminine. So that is the shloka. I felt like sharing because it was incidentally Tripadai Madhur has strong influence of Mahadevi Vade. That I will, if time permits, we will share here. If not, we will see in the next lecture demonstration. That being said, Chidambaram needs no introduction to anybody. Dikshita himself tells us Adhara Kshetram. Yedharadi Kshetrasthitam is Adhara Kshetram for all the Shiva temples. All Bhusura Trisahasram Nishwaram. He quotes of the Tillai Muvayiram, Tillai Muvayiram, or the 3000 Dikshitars who came out of Nataraja himself. But yes, we have a catch here. We are not going to be singing the Kedaram composition.
Not the other, both the two Kedaras
we are not going to be singing. We are not singing Natakuriti as well. We love bringing out very rare compositions to the forte, to spotlight, as much as we can do. So the first point of composition would be Raga Dhuni Bhinna Shatyam. Sampurna Veda equivalent is
Dhenuka.
But Dhenuka is completely different from Dhuni Bhinna Shatyam. Dhuni Bhinna Shatyam is Dhuni Bhinna Shatyam. Dhenuka is Dhenuka. Please do not confuse it with each other. This is Chidambareshwaram Chintayami in Adhidalam. Dhuni Bhinna Shatyam.
Chidambareshwaram Chintayami. Chidambareshwaram Chintayami Shivananda Gangadharam. Chidambareshwaram Chintayami Shivananda Gangadharam. Mrigadharam Chidambareshwaram Chidananda Natana Prakasham సచ్చిదానందనందన ప్రకాశం శివకామ వల్లి మన ప్రియకరం శివానంద గంగాధర చిదానంద నటన ప్రకాశం శివకామ వల్లి మన ప్రియకరం చిదం వరేశ్వరం వాసుకీ ప్రముఖాద్యుపాసితం వాసుకీ ప్రముఖాద్యుపాసితం వాసుదేవ గురు గుహాదివందితం వాసుకీ ప్రముఖాద్యుపాసితం వాసుదేవ గురు గుహాదివందితం భాస్కర శశి శేఖరం త్రినేత్రం భాస్కర శశి శేఖరం త్రినేత్రం భిన్న షడ్జరాగనుత ప్రసిద్ధం భాస్కర శశి శేఖరం త్రినేత్రం భిన్న షడ్జరాగనుత ప్రసిద్ధం చిదం వరేశ్వరం భాస్కర శశి శేఖరం త్రినేత్రం భిన్న షడ్జరాగనుత ప్రసిద్ధం చిదం వరేశ్వరం ప్రసిద్ధం చిదం వరేశ్వరం భిన్న షడ్జరాగనుత ప్రసిద్ధం చిదం వరేశ్వరం చిందయామి శివానంద గంగాధరం మృగధరం చిదం వరేశ్వరం
Nikshita very beautifully gives us essential pointers of Buddha Kshetra. It is Shivakama Valli Manapriyakaram, the goddess of the temple. I am unsure if you had noticed, but in all the Shiva Kritis that Nikshita has composed, there will be a mention about the goddess. But it is not necessary that in all the goddess Kritis that he has composed, Devi Kritis that he has composed, there will be a mention of Shiva. In all Shiva Kritis, there will be mention of Devi, either direct or indirect. If we take Chintaya Mahakandam Murakandam, for instance, there is no Kamakshi Sameta, there is no reference of Kamakshi, but it is in the Raga Bhairavi. So it comes
Bhairavi Prasangam.
Bhairavi Prasangam. So the goddess is hinted at that way. Now, in Chidambaram itself, there are almost 4 to 5 compositions on Yatraja. And all the 4 to 5 compositions, Shiva Kama Valli somehow finds her way. It is Vasuki Pramukhadhyupasitam. All the bhaktas or Vasuki is a snake who has worshipped there. Vasudeva Guru Guhadi Vanditam. Bhaskara Sashi Shekaram. Shiva has 3 eyes. Bhaskara is sun, Sashi is moon. Shashi Shekaram. Okay.
Trinetram.
Trinetram we can interpret. Dikshita himself we understand. So we should be able to understand. And Dhinya Shadja Ragamudra Prasiddham is a Ragamudra. It's a very beautiful Vibhagi Raga.
That is not exactly, not exactly, but you can.
It has,
but it has, it's not a Vibhagi. Definitely not a Vibhagi because it doesn't have a discordant Gayatri. Yes, singable Gayatri, let's put it that way.
But it is a very different raga, not usually, even though it's a very small composition, lyrics are not very difficult, nobody sings it.
In fact, I think we found it 2 days back.
Yeah, we found it 2 days back. We spent sleepless nights trying to bypass the lyrics. So that was about this composition. We have another small composition for Chidambaram. The raga, Tanukirti, Mishra Chaputala. చిదంబర నటరాజ మూర్తి
చిదంబర నటరాజ మూర్తి చిదంబర Madamba Shiva Kami Padim Madamba Shiva Kami Padim Madamba Shiva Kami Padim Madamba Shiva Kami Padim Madana Janaka Mahita Pashupati Madana Kamana Guru Guha Vinodam Madamba Shiva Kami Padim Madana Janaka Mahita Pashupati Madana Kamana Guru Guha Vinodam Sadi Rima Ripama Maga Kari Risani Tani Asani Nisasari Risari Rima Ripama Maga Kari Risani Tani Asani Nisasari Risari Pama Rima Pasani Sagari Sasani Dari Papa Magari Sani Chitam Bar Nataraja Murtim Sari Trimari Pama Maga Kari Risani Tani Asani Nisa Sari Risari Pama Rima Pasani Sagari Sasani Dari Papa Maga Risani Chidam Vara Nataraja Murtim Chintayami Atanu Kirtim
A haunting experience that only Dikshitar can give. There is no, I don't know, all the 72 has been exhausted by Dikshitar. Rather, the ragas have got exhausted being handled by Dikshitar. That being said, we will see how intelligently Dikshitar has inserted the raga mudra. Pallavi goes, Chintayami Atanu Kirti. Kirti refers to fame. And Tanu refers to a swarupa, a form or a body. Nataraja's temple, which is a varam, is Akasha Kshetra, out of the five elements. It is his temple for space element. So Nataraja is special here for not having a body. A Tanu Kirti. He is not having a body. He is bodiless. He is formless. That is what is special here.
That is what he is famous for.
That is what he is famous for. That is what he is famous for. That is what he is powerful for in this temple. A Tanu Kirti. Next on this is Sirgadi. Sirgadi has a very secluded, very, again it is a sanctuary that we can reach only by climbing steps. A sanctuary that it is made so that not Mara sanctuary, made so that not everybody can reach that easily. Bhairava in Sirgadi is very famous, very powerful. Visesha, that Kshetra Visesha of Sirgadi is Bhairava. He is also referred to as Satanatha. Dikshitar has composed a piece, Kala Bhairavam Bhajeham, in Raga Bhairavam, on this deity, in this Kshetra. There might be some eyebrows raising up, thinking that isn't Kala Bhairavam on Kashi, but Sampradaya Pradarshini, Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshini gives this clarity that it is not on Kashi, but on Siddhgadi,
on Kali.
Like we go back to the Madhyama Kala model.
శ్రీ కమలాపుర సోమస్కందం చిదంబరేశ్వర నటనందం శ్రీకాళీశ భైరవ స్కందం శివ స్వామి శైల గురుహస్కందం చింతయే.
Out of the four kshetras you mentioned,
కమలాపుర సోమస్కందం,
శ్రీ కమలాపుర సోమస్కందం, we have already visited the సారంగాపీస్.
చిదంబరేశ్వర నటనందం,
we had a double treat. We had Munivina Shatjam and the Tantamkirti.
Shivaswami Shaila Guru Guhaskandam,
we had an amazing Vidakari with emphasis on Guru Tattva.
Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam,
we are going to listen to the very rare Bhairavam. The Raga itself is very rare. You know, Tyagaraja Swami has composed a Kriti with the Raga, but his handling of the Raga is slightly different. Dikshitar gives lots of emphasis on Gamakas, the Sahityam, the lyrical content is given lots of emphasis, and it is a little slow moving chauka piece. And before we listen to Kala Bhairavam, Bhajeham the Bhairavam, I would like to start it off with a few verses from the Kala Bhairavashtakam.
దేవరాజ సేవ్యమాన పవన త్రిపంకజం వ్యాలయజ్ఞ సూత్ర బిందు శేఖరం కృపాకరం నారదాది యోగ వృంద వందితం దిగంబరం కాశికాపురాయి నాథ కాల భైరవం భజే.
That is the first stanza of the Kala Bhairava Ashtakam. I will jump to the third stanza.
శూలకంఠపాశదండపాణినం దిరాకరం శ్యామకారమాదిదేకమక్షరం నిరామయం భీమవిక్రమం ప్రభుం విచిత్రకాండవ్యప్రియం కాశికాపురారినాథ కాలభైరవం భజే.
We will have listened to this Kala Bhairavashtakam many times, but now let us listen to this Kala Bhairavam in Ragam Bhairavam Manikali, Kshetram Sirgali.
Kala Bhairavam Bhaje Hamanisham, Kala Bhairavam హరిశం కాళీపురవాసం భూతేశం కాల భైరవం భజేహం హరిశం పూరవాసం భూతేశం కాల భైరవం భజే. శూల చక్ర పాశ దండ హస్తం శూల చక్ర పాశ దండ హస్తం प्रशस्तम् शोक मोह वारण प्रशस्तम् काल भैरवम् नारदादि नूत श्याम गात्रम् नागय सूत्र विचित्रम् क्रूरतर पाप दण्डन च दूरम् दुरुगुह प्रियकरम् दिगम्बरम् पारिजासनस्य कृतनम् वाञ्छितार्थ फलदान चिन्तनम् धीरतरम् विधि कपाल धरणम् देवराज सेविताब्ज चरणम् काल भैरवम् वारिजासनस्य कृतनम् वाञ्छितार्थ फलदान चिन्तनम् धीरतरम् विधि कपाल धरणम् देवराज सेविताब्ज चरणम् काल भैरवम् भजेऽहम् हरनीशम् काडीपुरवासम् भूतेशम् काल भैरवम्
a big relief for me. Thank you. So the problem is there are no other kritis for you to refer. You have Shankaravana, you have like tens and thousands of Shankaravanams, you have that helping you.
Exactly.
This is like
this is Bhairavam. That is that sounds closely to Suryakantam. For some, it might sound close to Chakravaham, Saurashtram. These are the common allied ragas that people might associate it with, but this is none of the above. Bhairavam is Bhairavam, it's something very unique. And the Bhayanaka Rasam that this raga creates is so apt for the Bhayanaka Murti, the Ugra Murti that Lord Shiva takes as Kshetrapalaka. He is in the form of, he is in the fierce form. He is protecting us from all the evils that can, that might come to us. He doesn't want us to face any troubles in life. And Dikshita has chosen such a raga to induce Bhayanaka Rasam within us so that we are able to visualize that form of the Lord. If he could have easily, as he told, he could have easily sung it in Shankara Bharanam or Bhairavam, okay, easily name closely resembles Bhairavi, he could have easily sung it in Bhairavi or Saurashtram, Chakravaham, Toya Vegahini, he could have sung it in any other ragas, but he chose a special raga, Bhairavam. Can you repeat?
Kala Bhairavam
this makes us get afraid. I do not want to commit any mistakes. Who knows, Bhairava himself may come. And especially if a Mahan say Dikshita renders, why won't Bhairava come?
True, very true.
And for the sadhana that Yukshita had done, Mata Mantra sadhana and Sangeeta Nadopasana that he had done, if he just thinks of the moves that he wants to see, they will come rushing to meet him. Again, this is a point where Yukshita so much reflects the Kala Bhairava Ashtakam composed by Adi Shankara. I think that is what makes people misinterpret Kali Puravasam to Kashi Puravasam. This Kali Puravasam in the Pallavi refers to Seed Garden. Kali Puravasam Dutiyasham.
Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam.
Shri Kalisha Bhairava Spandam in Mahalingam Chinte Mahalinga Murtim. And this Kali Puravasam beautifully, you know, it connects each other. It's like a mirror and it's
Bimba Pratibimba.
Shula Chakra Pasha Danda Hastam. As I tried to recite the Kala Bhairava Ashtakam, which was my first time, the iconographic details of Bhairava, Yukshita loves portraying iconographic details of any deity that he is referring to. He does that, and each stanza finishes with Kala Bhairavam Bhaje, and this composition starts with
Kala Bhairavam Bhajeram.
And the first stanza starts with Devaraja Sevyamana Pavanagri Pankajam. This composition finishes with
Devaraja Sevitabja Charanam.
So much influence of Adi Shankara. I was speechless, and there was a reason I sang Tamil verses to begin off the lecture demonstration. Yukshita goes kshetra by kshetra singing in praise of all the deities situated there. This is not what Adi Shankara did. Adi Shankara went to a few select shrines. He did not come to, as of my knowledge, he did not sing anything in praise of Mahalinga Swami. Adi Shankara, I don't think he has composed any work specially on Mahalinga Swami. He has been to Kashi, Kanchi, a few pilgrimage spots he has been, but he has not gone like every village by village. He has not gone.
Probably we can say Yukshita is the Adi Shankara of South India.
No, I feel Yukshita has taken inspiration from the Tamil saints of Nayanmars. He has taken inspiration from them to travel to each and every small shrine and sing in praise of them. The Nayammars were those who sang in praise of every little shrine, Shiva temple that they went to. He has also taken the influence of Alvars, and maybe that we will reserve it for some other time. Yukshita has also been influenced by the Sri Vaishnava philosophy, as much as he is influenced by the Shaiva philosophy. Shaiva philosophy, Kala Bhairava appears. He is very important, fierce from the Shaiva aspect. And we have another composition, Rudrakopajata Veerabhadra is another fierce aspect of Lord Shiva.
In Rudrapriya.
In Raga Rudrapriya. The choice of ragas, the choice of talas, if it is a very complicated ragam, Yukshita will make us little easy for us by putting it in Adi Talam or Mishra Chapu or Upakam. It will not be again a jampa or a mattiya or something like that, unless it is in Avagraha Vada business. Yukshita loves the concept of Kamboji with Atatala combination.
Yeah. Most of his Kamboji are in
Atatala,
except for one Kailasanath, but that also upon extension because it's Mishra Chapu. Upon extension, it would fit into Atatala.
All that being said, we have come to the end of our lecture demonstration. Before we wind up our lecture demonstration, I would love to add some more about Mahalinga Swami and Bhagat Pichamba. I was so smitten by Dhanyashi that I couldn't speak more on Bhagat Pichamba especially. two, three points on her, and we will move on to the Mangalam.
Sure.
The Mangalam will be a dedication to the Mookambika Shrine in the temple. The Mookambika Shrine hosts a beautiful Sri Chakra. And even though Deekshitar has not composed this piece on that particular shrine, it so happens that this piece fits for her. I already told about the reference of the Sthala Purana and Sthala Purana and the 36 Teerthams that are there in Madhyarjunama Tiruvadaimurugan. Out of the 36 Teerthams, Karunyamrita Teertham is a very prominent one, and that is where all the rishis, siddhas, bhaktas take a holy dip. Deekshitar tells in the Madhyama Kalam of Charanam in Paradevata as Karuna Rasa Pravahini. He talks about this Teertham of the temple, the temple tank. Pravaham is a word that is used to describe a liquid, and this so well reflects the Sthala Teertham, the Karunyamrita Teertham.
Karuna Rasa Pravahini Kaulini Kali Kalmasha Nashini Hamsini. Karuna Rasa Pravahini.
There is another point that I would like to throw light on. Amba, or Devi here, is enshrined with the name of Brihat Kuchamba or Brihat Sundara Kuchamba. That is her more elaborate. She has a huge name. And Swami is Mahalinga Swami. In Tamil, he is called as Periyanayagar. If he is Periyanayagar, Devi should be Periyanayagi. But that is not so here. And she has an extended name in Tamil also. She is called Perum Nalamamulai Nayagi. That so well reflects the Sanskrit name which she has. Brihat is big. Kucham refers to her breasts. Amba, Brihat Sundara Kuchamba, is the one who has huge, beautiful breasts. This also, when we talk about Kuchamba, I am tempted to quote about Apita Kuchamba, who is enshrined in Arunachal. She is called Apita Kuchamba because nobody has tasted her directly. She has given out her karuna only in the form of milk in a cup or as a prasadam. She has the breasts that are untasted. Apita Kuchamba. Deekshitar, he does this to the goddess even at Tanjavur.
Probably, I think that's why Deekshitar has, if there is a Shiva temple, if he is visiting a Shiva temple and if there is a Lord Shiva on whom he is sitting, he would have definitely sung on the goddess also. But it's only at Tiruvannamalai that he has sung about Shiva. He has mentioned goddess and he has left goddess. He didn't want to touch. He didn't even taste her. Okay.
Even Ganapati and Subramanya have not tasted her. Okay. Who are we? So with her karuna, with her abundant blessings, it is by her will that the Kshetra itself shines. It is called Shakti Puram. The goddess is in her all splendor. She is inviting her devotees to come to Kailasham. I told Kailasham itself is here, but she is telling, no, we will soon go back there, so you better be ready. So all the devas come to Bhulokam to perform puja at Tiruvannamalai. So all the devas, after performing puja, coming to the goddess's shrine, and like an assembly, they are waiting. They are waiting for the goddess to give orders to start to start off to Kailash.
Just the way Thiruvarur in Aditya Chandravari,
she's taking them to Kailash. She is the one who got the first Upadesa from Shiva, the Shiva Rahasya, as I told. So she is being the guru, she is being the mother for the children around. Because he is in the Parat Brahma Tattva Swarupam. He cannot open his mouth and talk. He is always Lakshana Murti in a Mona Swarupam. Mona Nila, Mona Nilai, or in the state of Mona. He will not open his mouth and talk. He is in this Tejomaya Swarupam. He is a father.
And only one who can perceive that is
the mother, Bharat Kuchamba. I am tempted to give more details about Paradevata, the Kriti Dhanyashi, after which we will wind up with the Mangala. It is Charu Chandrahasini. Sharat Chandra Vadana is a phrase that Adi Shankara uses in Saundarya Tagari. Devi's face is always compared to a full moon. That is not in a normal full moon, to the moon in the Sharat Rutu, in the season of autumn. Why is autumn so special? Autumn is a season where there are not many clouds in the sky. And so the moon has a full bright view and there is no obstruction between the moon and the earth. And Sharat Purnima, the Purnami that comes after the Sharat Navaratri, is a very powerful Purnami for all those worshipping the goddess. In that Purnami, we get the complete brilliance, we feel the complete brilliance from the moon. So she is compared to the phase of the autumnal moon, Sharat Chandra Vadana. In Kwanath Kanchi Dama, the Shlokam, Kwanath Kanchi Dama Kali Kalabhasthananata Parikshina Madhye Parinata Sharat Chandra Vadana Dhanur Banan Pasham Shrini Mavidadana Karadalayi Urastadastam Nahe Uramati Kuraho Purushika. It tells the goddess's face is like the autumnal moon. Again, Lalita Sahasranam also, there are many such references. Chidananda Mahalinga Mohini or Mohini. Again, Dikshita, his guru's name, Chidananda Natha, because Shiva is giving the Upadesham of Shiva Rahasyams to Devi, yes. Chidananda, the Mahalinga, his Mohini, his Paradevata, Bharat Kuchamba. So we have, time is up and we are already running late by 10-11 minutes. So, as an ode to the Sri Chakra and the beautiful eternal Mukambika residing in the temple, we will wind up this concert, lecture, demonstration with a Mangalam, with Aga Vasanta, Adichara.
Mangalam Jaya Mangalam Mangalam Jaya Mangalam Mama Varaja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam Jaya Mangalam Mama Varaja Matangi Jaya Jaya Mangalam Jaya Mangalam Mama Varaja Matangi Jaya Mangalam Mangalam Jaya Mangalam Gangadhar Yuvati Parameshwari Mangala Varadayini Jagadishwari Gangadhar Yuvati Parameshwari Mangala Varadayini Jagadishwari Sankatanashini Jaya Mangalam Sadguru Guha Janani Jaya Mangalam Sankata Nashini Jaya Mangalam. सद्गुरु गुह जननी शुभ मंगलम मंगलम जय मंगलम मामवराज मातंगी जय जय मंगलम मंगलम जय मंगलम मंगलम मंगलम
With this, we wind up our lecture demonstration, Chintage Mahalingam Murti. This was just an attempt to scratch the surface of another set of Yukshita's compositions. We offer this as flowers to the humble feet of Yukshita, as a humble offering to the lotus feet of Yukshita. Brihat Sundara Kuchamba Sameta Mahalinga Swami and our Ishta Devata, Yagarajan. Shri Guru Bhupo Jai.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.